Okay. So I have plantar fasciitis, and I used to have it in both of my feet, and now I have it in 1 foot, and it's still really painful. So I've had it for probably 7 months, and when I had it in both feet, it was probably for about 4 or 5 months, and then it just stopped hurting in one of my feet, and now it's still really bad in the other. So I thought I would make a massage video on how to, what would feel nice if you have plantar fasciitis, what sort of massage would feel nice. So I'm going to do that tonight. I'm going to make that video and just talk a little bit about what it feels like and everything that goes with that. So in the country. So the way that I got plantar fasciitis is, so I was wearing barefoot shoes when I worked out, and I would work on the treadmill. I walk really fast on the treadmill for like 45 minutes to an hour, and I did that over maybe 3 or 4 months, and then all of a sudden my feet started sort of just aching, and I always thought, oh, it's probably just because I work on my feet all day, I'm always on my feet, and I don't have the right shoes. But then it started hurting like really bad, like right in the morning when I would step off the bed, it would be like a really sharp pain in my heel, and then also the ball of my foot as well, and it sort of looked blue, like bruised with blue on the bottom of my feet. And I was like, oh fuck, this is definitely a thing. This has got to be plantar fasciitis. And it is. And so
your feet definitely look like they need some lotion. So let's go ahead and put some lotion on them. Those feet, Nomi.
actually had like a crazy thing happen when I was wearing the shoes at work. Like, I was so pissed off when this happened. I could not believe that this should happen. Right? Okay, so I'm at work and I'm in a couple's massage. And the couple's massage was almost over, just a few more minutes. And was about to go to behind us, and when I stood up from the stool and I stepped back, my shoe would not follow me. It was like suctioned to the ground. And so when I pulled my foot back to step back, my shoe stayed there, and so I ended up tumbling over backwards the stool, crashing onto my butt and smashing my head against the counter in a couple's massage. I was mortified. And it was because those freaking shoes stuck to the bottom of the floor. They like suctioned. And yeah, so I don't wear them to massage anymore. But my first point was that I feel that I do so much. I feel like my plantar fasciitis feels better if I don't always wear specialized things. So lately I've been back to my regular just massaging without any shoes on, just wearing socks. And it does help. I feel it's way better than any of those supports, even though it hurts initially, but everything hurts. And then it just feels better and I can massage the whole day like that. So yeah, anyway, the arch is a really nice area to dig in, to get in there, to really dig into this tissues. get a good foot rub. I think so much anxiety can be released from the feet. You could have a really, really good night's sleep with a really deep foot massage.
Mommy, why is he doing that?
So if he goes under the cover, that would be perfect. But he's not going to, and his face is going to show up this whole video.
Mommy, why was he doing that?
Because he saw a toe.
Oh, that's cute.
But honey, the thing is focusing on his face, and your feet are blurred.
Mama, look at... Try nudging him underneath the covers.
No, because he'll run. Let him go naturally.
He has... Mommy, he looks... He looks so cute.
I know. He looks so cute, but the feet are blurred, girl. And this is a video about feet.
I know. Look at him. He is so nosy. Mommy, look at this. Why is he doing that? Did he need to, like, scratch his chin?
He wants to be the center of attention.
He's doing this because he wants to be the center of attention, and he knows something's going on. And so he's going to be right here. He's a smart kitty.
Sullivan, I don't want to kick you out.
And he was, like, smelling my feet. He's like, what's going on here?